I'm Kelly from A Side of Sweet, and I am really excited for today's video. We are jumping back into photography tutorials, but this time we're talking about one of my favorite topics, which is Photoshop. I'm going to show you how to convert all of your Lightroom presets into Photoshop actions in just a few easy steps. On top of that, I'm going to show you this amazing hack that's going to help you streamline your preset workflow and make it easier to choose the right preset for your image. I'm 90% sure you haven't seen this anywhere else, and I'm hoping that I'm going to blow your mind today. Before we get started though, if you're new around here, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And of course, if you want to see more of my work and what I'm up to on a daily basis, you can find me on Instagram at @asideofsweet. Without further ado, let's jump into the video. To do this technique, you're going to need Adobe Lightroom and Adobe Photoshop. So the first step is opening Lightroom and importing basically any random image. It doesn't really matter what it looks like. And then hit the develop button. As you can see, you know, I have all my presets already imported in here. Then you just need to pick the preset that you want to transfer to a Photoshop action. All right, so I really have been loving the Do You Travel preset collection lately. I find that they really work well for everything from travel to food. You want to select the preset that you want to transfer into Photoshop. So as you can see, you know, this is applied to my photo. All the adjustments are here. And then you want to right click on the photo, go to edit in, and we want to open this in Photoshop, but you don't want to hit the edit in Photoshop. You want to open it as a smart object in Photoshop. So as you can see, that opened it up into Photoshop. In this kind of navigation tab here, it's a smart object, so you can see it looks kind of like a picture frame. So you want to double click that, and it actually opens up the preset edits in Camera Raw, which is just an extension of Photoshop that comes included with it. All the adjustments that the preset had are put in here. So everything from kind of the basic edits, you can see sharpening and noise reduction are in there. Even the split toning, kind of HSL tab is in there. Everything is in there that you kind of can find with Lightroom. And that's why I really love Camera Raw. You can really do anything that you can do in Lightroom, and maybe even in an easier way with the combination of Camera Raw and Photoshop. The next step is to save these settings. So you want to go up under this basic tab. There's this little three-line box and hit save settings. So the first step is actually to save this as a Camera Raw preset. I usually uncheck the exposure box just because the exposure really varies from photo to photo, but I leave all the other boxes checked. Hit save and then find a name for your preset. So as you can see, I've already been working on importing all these Do You Travel presets. So I have them all labeled DYT and then the name of the collection. So this is the Egypt collection, so DYT Egypt 1. So we'll save that, hit OK, and that's the first step. Next thing you need to do is just open any random photo in Photoshop. It doesn't matter what it is. This is actually from my Hong Kong trip that I did a few weeks ago. I'm just working on editing the photos. So the next thing you're going to do is there's this Actions tab, and if you can't see that, just go up to Window and make sure you have Actions checked. You're going to create a new folder to help you stay organized. So for this one, it's going to be DYT Egypt. Hit OK. There's our new folder. And then you're going to make a new action. So create new action. It's this little post-it note icon here. And this one is Egypt 1, the record button. So as you can see now, this turned red because it's recording what I do. So it's going to basically just replicate every keystroke that I take within Photoshop on that image. The first step is duplicating the background. So you want to drag the background layer onto this little post-it icon, makes a copy of the background. The reason you want to do this is because then you always have the original photo to go back to, and you're not kind of stuck once you apply the preset. So the background copy layer is selected. You go to the Filter tab, Camera Raw Filter. This opens up the Camera Raw dialog box again. As you can see, there are no edits or presets applied yet. Go to that three little line icon and hit Apply Preset. Find the preset that you created, so in this case, DYT Egypt 1. And there it goes, it applies the preset. So hit OK. So now that's opened back up in Photoshop, and you just want to stop the recording at this point. And that's it. So now you have that Lightroom action transferred in so you can use it in Photoshop. I'm going to just delete this preset right now, and I'll show you how that works. So you just want to find the action you want to use in Photoshop, select Egypt and hit play, and there you can see it applied the preset. One of my favorite things about using actions in Photoshop is that it's how the edits are applied.
So in Lightroom, there isn't really an easy way to do this. You have to adjust each setting individually and try to guess and check which one is going to give you the look you want. A lot of times I just want to, you know, kind of do what the original author of the preset intended, but I just don't want it to affect the image so strongly. So then you just hit the opacity of the layer that you created. And as you can see, you can slide in between basically not having the preset show up at all and having it full strength. Kind of find that sweet spot. The other thing you can do when you're using Photoshop actions is you can stack actions or you can use more than one. So for this, make sure you have the background layer selected, and then we'll just pick another random, let's say the Foodie 4 collection. So I'm going to hit the preset for this that I've already created. And then as you can see, I have this one kind of applied at full strength now, and I can kind of play with that. You really can apply two different presets or, you know, as many presets as you want to the same photo. If just decreasing the opacity of the action isn't enough for you, let's say you find that, you know, you really like the Foodie 3 preset, but as you can see, there's a ton of noise in the preset and it may not be quite the right fit for what you're going for. You still have the ability to tweak all the individual things. We'll just manually duplicate that layer, and instead of applying the action, just go directly into the Camera Raw Filter tab, find the preset, and apply the preset in Camera Raw. And that way you can adjust the individual parameters of the action without just decreasing the opacity. Then you can go back in, you can still adjust the opacity, but you retain that individual control that people love about using actions in Lightroom. Okay, so I'm gonna just take a pause here and import all the other Egypt presets in the collection into Photoshop. And then I'm gonna share with you this amazing way that you can streamline your preset use to easily choose the best one that fits your image. So as you can see, I have all of those presets loaded into Photoshop now under the Actions tab. So I just repeated all the steps that we went through. What we're going to do is we're going to create one huge final action that applies every single preset with one step. I'm going to do a final new preset, and I'm going to name this one Egypt Apply All, or, you know, whatever you want. Hit the record button, and then I'm going to record myself applying each action to the same photo. So select, hit play. And now this is the important step in order to have success with this process, is that you have to reselect the layer that you want copied in every time you apply this action. So click the background layer again, go to Egypt 2, hit play, hit the background again, and so on until you have all the actions in the set combined. And then you're gonna hit stop. This is a big long action, so I'm gonna just collapse that container. Let's see this baby in action. Hit play under the apply all action. Because you're doing 9 separate actions all in one, this is gonna take a few minutes to apply. So you're gonna get that spinning wheel of death, and you just have to be patient and have a couple drinks or a cup of coffee. It actually didn't take too long. And then as you can see, every single preset is applied here in full strength. And the nice thing is they're all numbered in the order of what the preset is. So background copy is Egypt 1, 2 is Egypt 2, 3 is Egypt 3, you know, so you can tell which one you're working with. So when you find one, then you can easily apply that to the rest of your workflow. All you need to do is hit this View Layer button, and it'll toggle it on and off. So, you know, you can say, oh, do I like this one better? Or do I like that one better? Or you can use multiple just like we went through before. And then when you find one that works the best, then you can adjust the opacity and kind of see what's the best fit for your photo. It's so slick. And honestly, with the combination of being able to do that, being able to stack presets, and being able to adjust the opacity of presets, honestly, we'll never open Lightroom again. Photoshop is just so much easier. It's so much more powerful when it comes to editing photos.
And that's all there is to it. All those Lightroom presets converted into Photoshop actions so you never have to open Lightroom again. And what do you think about that hack of combining all your presets so you can kind of streamline your selection? I'd love to hear if this is something you've already been doing or if this is something new that you can incorporate into your workflow. So make sure you leave me a comment and let me know. If you found this video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And of course, hit that subscribe button so we can keep in touch. And of course, you can find me on Instagram at @asideofsweet. Thanks so much for watching and for all your support. I will see you in my next video.